therapist with Smart Therapy, Washington Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. So today we're going to be talking about labral tears, a common injury seen in athletes as well as the active population. First, we're going to talk about what a labrum is and what its function is. We're going to talk about different types of labral injuries as well as different tests for each one. And lastly, we're going to talk about different treatments for labral tears as well as impingements. So what is a labrum? A labrum goes around the hip joint, and what it does is it deepens the hip joint, leading to more stability and shock absorption in the hip. So tears can be caused from dysplastic hips, which is also a bony abnormality, or trauma or repetitive wear and tear. In the case of labral tears, there can be a femoral acetabular impingement, or abbreviated FAI. What that is there's too much bone on some part of the hip, so the bone can't move appropriately. An FAI can be shown on either an x-ray or an ultrasound. What they're looking for is where the extra bone is and how they can fix it. First, let's talk about a normal hip. A normal hip has a femoral head and there's a nice curve that sits right below it. The head of the femur sits within an acetabulum. It lets it move appropriately so the labrum does not get hit. The first lesion is called a cam lesion. What that is on the neck of the femur, there's too much bone. When it sits in the acetabulum, it bumps up against the labrum, causing it to fray or to tear. The next type of lesion is a pincer lesion. This is when, on the acetabulum, there's too much bone that sticks out. So when the head of the femur rubs up against the bone, it peels off the labrum, causing a tear. The last type is a mixed type. So not only is there a pincer lesion on the acetabulum, there's also a cam lesion on the femoral neck. So it bumps up against each other, causing the peeling back and the tearing of a labrum. When the patient comes to see you, they will usually complain of pain in what's called the C sign. The pain will be at the front and the back of their hand as they grab their hip. Next, we're going to talk about different tests that your physician or your physical therapist can do to test to see if you have an impingement or a labral tear. The first test we're going to do is just bringing the knee in towards the chest. The patient will complain of pinching in the front of the hip if they have an impingement or a tear. So all you do, bring the knee in towards the chest and bring it back down. The next test is called the FABER. It stands for flexion, abduction, external rotation. The patient will complain of pinching in the hip or pain, and they will also have decreased range of motion. You place their ankle on their knee and let their knee drop down towards the table. The last test is called a FADER. It stands for flexion, adduction, and internal rotation. The patient will also complain of pinching in the hip or pain, and you're looking for decreased range of motion. You bring their knee up towards their chest, and then rotate their leg out towards you, and bring it back down. Now on to treatment. There are four main go-tos for what can be done for a FAI or a labral tear. The first thing is to do nothing. Probably not the best choice, as you're not going to be fixing anything. The next is physical therapy. Going to physical therapy will help increase your strength, your flexibility, and hopefully decrease the rubbing of the bones and the labrum and decreasing your pain. The next option is a cortisone injection. What they do is they inject an anti-inflammatory within your joint to help with the inflammation. The one downfall is you can only have so many cortisone injections. The last option is surgery. What they can do is repair or reconstruct the labrum as well as shave down the extra bone. After that, you would go to physical therapy where they would get you back to your previous level of function. Here at WASM and Smart Therapy, we have a great team of doctors and physical therapists who can help you if you think you have a labral tear or an acetabular impingement.
Thank you.